Hello everyone, this is Jingle Chinese. 我是赵老师。今天我们来继续介绍 email response, 电子邮件。今天我们的目标是要给刘飞写一封电子邮件，回答他的问题。好，第一步我们先来读一读电子邮件。Okay, 我们看啊，这个就是我们的电子邮件。好，第一个我们看看谁。一个人，你们不知道名字，就是一个什么飞，对不对？飞飞 send the email to me. I'm Wang, right? And then, so what is the background? Let's see the background. So, 下个月我们家要 don't know this too, right? 一个从美国来的学生。哦，有个从美国来的学生。我知道去年有一个啊，什么东西生 ，and then you don't know this word 生学生，哎 ，just think 学生在你家住过，所以想问几个问题 ，OK？So、okay. there is a background. He gonna ask me some questions. So the background is a there gonna be a student from America, right? And then he also knows last year. So.一个什么生在你家住过 lived at your house, 然后几个问题。周一到周 okay, here is also the background. 周一到周五我们会去学校上课。但是到了周末不知道安排什么活动 don't know what to do. Don't highlight two questions. First question.你以前跟交换生做过哪些活动？哪些活动 ？Second question， 要是我带他去这里的 something or something， 你觉得他会喜欢吗？为什么 ？OK. So let's learn some vocabulary right now. 交换生。So, if you think 学生, that's very, very close. You can actually, if you really don't know this two word, just say 学生, right? A 学生 from America, 从美国来的学生。所以交换生, exchange student, 交换。So, 我打算申请去中国做交换生。All the keyword from AP test.我打算申请去中国做交换生。Next word, very important, you don't know, it's okay. So it's called 接待。It means to host, to give a reception. So you are very friendly, so you're gonna host this exchange student. 所以我要接待一位从中国来的交换生。So here, 为 is a measure word for student.So here, if you really don't recognize, just change to 一个, right? You know, the measure word is after number, 一个从中国来的交换生。Another word very important is this one we all know, right? 茶 something, 茶馆 tea house. 我想去茶馆喝茶看表演吃小吃茶馆。So this one is 馆 so 饭馆茶馆旅馆 okay, we can also have a 图书馆餐馆 During the class, we'll have a time to watch this 老舍 tea house 的真实语料 We'll answer those three questions 中国人在茶馆做什么中国的茶馆和美国的星巴克有什么不一样？你觉得你的美国朋友会喜欢茶馆吗？为什么 ？Okay, so last word, 小吃街。所以我打算带交换生去小吃街吃糖葫芦。We learned the 糖葫芦 right? The hulu.com, the hulu, 糖葫芦 So food street or snack street. So during the class, we have watched the 王府井小吃街. So now let's read this again. So, 谁 send email 是刘飞。So, 谁 received email? So, you are 王凯。So, the background. 所以下个月我家要接待一位美国来的学生。And then, I know, 我知道去年 last year, 有一个交换生在你家住过。所以他要问几个问题。So, 周一到周五要去学校上课。周末不知道做什么。所以 question one is, 你以前跟交换生做过什么活动? That's a question one. The question two is, 我要是我带他, who is 他? That 交换生去茶馆, right, 茶馆 or 小吃街。你觉得他会喜欢吗?为什么? So now you will understand the whole question, right? So always analyze who, what, and then highlight two questions. And then think about these two questions. When, 什么时候? So this one is really tricky. So first question is 你以前, so before, 你以前跟交换生做过。So you have to answer, 我以前跟交换生做过。You don't say 我要, right? 我以前做过。And then the second question is, 要是我带他去这里的。So this one is gonna happen in future, right? 如果你带他去茶馆或小吃街,他会喜欢吗? So you need to analyze what time. So the first one is talk about before. The second one is talk about future. And then where? So...This one, 你以前跟交换生做过哪些活动? This, 你可以在中国。比如说王凯是住在中国的,所以我可以带着交换生在中国做了什么。也可以王凯,你是在美国的。如果一个中国的交换生, a Chinese exchange student come to America, so what activity you have done? Another one is,要是我带他去这里的 ,this 这里 means China, 这里的茶馆或小吃街,这里是中国的茶馆或小吃街,你觉得他会喜欢吗?为什么?好 ,here, how is you need to explain your answer. That is how you analyze the email. So, remember here, 刘飞王凯,一个人呢是要刘飞他要接待学生 It's in the future. And then 你呢王凯去年接待了交换生。OK, two questions. First one is, 那交你做了什么活动?第二个就是 question two, 茶馆或小吃街 whether he will like it or not. And then think about what time and where, and then here is your turn to answer the question. So,Then you can start to talk about, so, 刘飞你好 If you don't recognize the character, just say, 你好很高兴收到你的邮件 OK, let's talk about background. 从你的邮件中呢我知道你家要接待一个交换生哦、oh, 太好了我觉得你一定会很喜欢这次体验 And then, so, answer two questions. 关于你的第一个问题OK, 你要回答我以前跟交换生做了什么什么什么。OK, regarding to your second question, OK, 你觉得他会喜欢吗?嗯,我觉得他会喜欢。我觉得他会喜欢茶馆和小世界。You can also talk about, 我觉得他会喜欢茶馆,可能不喜欢小世界。And then talk about why. And well, I think, 我觉得他会喜欢小世界。不喜欢茶馆 and talk about why. And then end the email, I hope, 我希望我的邮件对你有帮助。然后你可以如果还有问题可以再给我写信。So that's the whole thing about the email template. Okay, now let's write the email. Start with a greeting. 你好。Thank you for email. 很高兴收到你的邮件。从你的邮件中我知道 OK, demonstrate you understand the email. 你知道我知道你要接待一个交换生。你不知道做什么好我来说说我的建议我的想法。 Okay, so, 你知道了什么？我们刚才已经讲过了。好，从你的邮件中我知道你家要接待交换生，但是不知道做什么活动比较好。我来说说我的建议，我的想法。哦，关于的第一个问题。So the first question mark. So 那是第一个问题。Okay, 文化活动。Talk about five cents, right? First, 吃。Always think about 你可以吃，吃特色食物，吃中国菜，吃美国菜。Okay, 吃小吃。OK, 看，你可以去看，比如说看表演，看电影，看书，都是文化活动。OK, then, 去参观，参观旅游景点，参观高中，参观博物馆， or 你还可以参加，那你可以参加俱乐部，参加比赛，参加辩论队。They are all related to cultural activity. So just choose the three you like the most.When you write down your answer, always use answer, give an example, and reason. So when you have, if you have enough time, please use answer, example, and reason. 所以关于你的第一个问题 okay, in the exam, if you really don't recognize the 交换生, you can just write, 我们以前做过很多活动, right? Then you don't need to type the 交换生. And then 首先我们去了超市。我们买了很多特色食物，哎，比如，而且我们还去了电影院，因为我们都非常喜欢。我们去了电影院 ，give example， 我们看了一个电影，然后我们都非常喜欢看电影。你在中国你可以看到《流浪地球》，在美国你也可以看《流浪地球》这个电影。然后呢，然后告诉我一些 reason， 为什么要看中国电影呢？可以学语言，可以了解中国文化。然后呢 ，depends on which location you choose。你还可以说我们去参观了高中。然后你还因为可以帮助交换生认识更多的朋友，是一次非常有意思的体验。So that is so. 如果你有时间 ，write down your three favorite activities. Okay, 去超市看电影，认识更多朋友。Talk about your own act.Talk about three activities. 好，关于你的第一个问题，我们做过很多活动。Now it's your turn to type. So, the second question. 关于你的第二个问题 ,let's answer the second question. Remember the second question is find the second and third question mark. Wait.我要是我带他去茶馆小吃街他会喜欢吗 Here I choose to say 他更喜欢小吃街 You can choose say 他更喜欢茶馆 Or you can also say 他我觉得他会喜欢茶馆和小吃街 Or you can say 我觉得茶馆和小吃街他都不喜欢 So first 首先在小吃街 give three reasons 你可以吃到特色食物可以了解中国文化，对不对？然后在小，而且在小吃街，你可以和老板讲价啊。在中国的小吃街，你可以说啊，便宜点儿什么，学习地道的中文。地道 in a conversation, we have learned that word. And then third, when you talk about two reasons, when you cannot think another one, you can always talk about another option is not ideal.所以另外也许有的交换生不喜欢喝茶在我们学校很多学生不喜欢喝茶所以你需要问一问他那如果去茶馆就是看表演 So after watching that video they know 在茶馆你可以看表演看变脸看功夫你可以不喝茶 So you can also use your own answers So nowThink about three things and then write your answer for the second question. So, the last step. 我希望我的邮件对你有帮助。祝好。Also, if you have more things to say, you can say, 如果你有别的问题,请再给我邮件,或者请你告诉我你的交换生喜不喜欢茶馆。Oh,Now let's review those words. 交换生接待茶馆 and 小吃店。During the exam, make sure you pay attention to the question and highlight two or three questions. And you follow the template. And then try to use at least three sentences to answer each question. Try to use at least five connecting words. And always, always check if your characters are correct. If you have time, reread your email. Make sure all the characters are correct.College board rubrics. That's it. Follow Jing Chinese. See you next time.